friends, we'll solve problem on curvilinear motion. See what is given in problem. A car starts from rest at t equal to 0 along a circular track of radius 200 meters. The rate of increase in speed of the car is uniform. At the end of 60 seconds, speed of the car is 24 km per hour. Find the tangential and normal components of acceleration at t equal to 30 seconds. Now here, what is given in problem? Step by step, if you will write here what is given. First one, car starts from rest at t equal to 0. That means what is given? Initially, velocity of car is 0. Car starts from rest along a circular track of radius 200 meters. That means what is given? Rho equal to 200 meters. The rate of increase in the speed of the car is uniform. What it represents? Rate of increase of speed with respect to time is nothing but tangential component of acceleration, and it is given as it is constant. That means at is constant is given. It is constant. Then at the end of 60 seconds, that means when t equal to 60 seconds, the speed of the car, means velocity of car, you can say is 24 km per hour. Now this kilometer per hour will convert in meters per second. If we'll convert, that means 24 into 1000 divided by hour means 3600, this final velocity comes out to be 6.66 meters per second. Now you know final velocity is 6.66, initial velocity is 0. You know tangential component of acceleration constant, time t is also given 60 seconds. Using this one, tangential component of acceleration is easily possible. You know tangential component of acceleration is always change in speed upon time. Change in speed means final speed minus initial speed upon time t. Final speed is 6.66, initial is 0, and time interval is what, 60. That means what we'll get here? Tangential component of acceleration comes out to be 0.111 meter per second square. Now you know tangential component of acceleration. As at is known, now what is asked in problem is find the tangential and normal components of acceleration at t equal to 30 seconds. Now at remains constant. Now what you have to find out is at 30 seconds. What data initially given is at 60 seconds. Using that one you are getting at. Now there is no role of the 60 second. What is asked in problem at 30 second? To find out this one at 30 second, first an normal component of acceleration, if you want to find out, it is v square upon rho. That means you have to find out what is the speed of car at t equal to 30 second. If you want to find out what is the speed of car, at 30 second, simple equation of kinematics v. We are finding at 30 seconds, so say this is 30 equal to u plus at into t. This is tangential component of acceleration into time. U, what is given, is 0. At is 0.111 into time is 30 seconds. That means what we will get here? What is speed of car at 30 seconds? Where this answer comes out to be 3.33 meters per second. Now, as you know what is the speed of car at 30 seconds, you have to find out tangential and normal component of acceleration. As speed is known, normal component of acceleration easily possible. How will get normal component of acceleration? An equal to v square upon rho. V is nothing but velocity at 30 seconds. It's square upon rho. What is the velocity you have calculated is 3.33 square upon radius of curvature of path. What is given is, or radius of that curved road what is given is 200 meters. If you find out, this an comes out to be 0.0554 meters per second square. Now you are getting an. At is a constant already you have calculated, which is equal to 0.111 meters per second square. What is the asking problem? Find normal component of acceleration and find tangential and normal component of acceleration. That means where normal component of acceleration is 0.0554 meters per second square, and 80 also we calculated, which is nothing but 0.111 meter per second square. In this problem, resultant acceleration is also possible, which is not asked in problem, but maybe you can see if it is asked in problem, how will tackle such part extra. Find resultant acceleration. To find out resultant acceleration, where resultant acceleration is resultant of at and an, applying Pythagoras theorem, easily we will get resultant acceleration of particle, where a can be calculated using this equation at square plus an square. If we substitute here value of at is 0.111 square plus an is 0.0554 and its square. Therefore, resultant acceleration what we will get here is, if we will calculate using calculator, this comes out to be 0.124 meter per second square. So, this is extra part you have solved. That means, in case in any problem, if after these components resultant, if you want to find out resultant acceleration, if you want to find out resultant acceleration, what you are getting is 0.124 meter per second square. Thank you.